Okay, I will. Whatever, I'm just gonna go through high school and get all A's and get into the best college. I honestly don't care about anything else. Getting friends, pfft, whatever. Alright, I'm getting on the bus now, so I might as well try to be social. Hey guys, it's my birthday today, so be nice to me. Eh, whatever. I'm definitely smarter than them anyways. I'll just sleep the rest of the way to school.
Hey man, I'm sorry about what just happened.
No need to be sorry. They're stupid anyways. Wait, who are you? What is this?
I am-
Actually, I don't care, you're. Just go away.
Hey, I know what you are thinking right now. All you care about is getting good grades and making a good college application and nothing else. You don't care about anyone but yourself. Do you know how? Because I thought the same way 4 years ago and I suggest you listen to what I'm about to say. Because it will help you in the future, and this is serious.
Wait, how do you know what I want? If you're that smart, then go ahead, enlighten me, whatever.
Okay, one more thing. I'm not going to say the real names of any of my teachers I mentioned because of, well, a potentially paradoxical situation.
Huh? How could a paradox come from-
Just don't worry about it. Alright, here we go. My story starts before high school even began, with who I was as a person. I was an arrogant, snobby, asocial person with no friends and no life except for playing many musical instruments and getting straight A's in class. Even though I felt happy with how my life was going, deep down somewhere, I knew I was emotionless. I was basically like Data from Star Trek, no feelings for anything with an incapability to even have a good conversation. If I need to describe myself with one word, I would describe myself as empty. Maybe even a little depressed as well. Pretending to look happy when in reality, I'm just completely down in the dumps. Well, little did I know that the process of high school would be the complete remaking of who I was as a person, and I cannot be grateful enough for my high school experience. So this is the story of how high school changed my life with every important aspect that contributed to my growth into what I am today. When I made my high school schedule, I decided to take computer graphics, a class that I was originally fond of because I wanted to learn more about digital art, and already on the first few days, I got what I expected. Little did I know that this insignificant decision to my high school credits, as well as deciding to sit in the corner of the room, literally spiraled into everything that has made me who I am now. I sat next to someone who was playing a strange game on his computer, and no matter how many times the teacher told him to stop, he never did. Then, he convinced the person directly to his right to play the game as well. Seeing those two play this game for my first week of school and seeing that this game was very intricate, I took my first steps into social interaction pretty much ever and asked the guy sitting next to me about what the game was and how to play. After that, I quickly became friends with the two people next to me as well as one other freshman who was in my PE class and also played Magic: The Gathering, a card game they'll never forget about and will always enjoy. The same game that the two people were playing on their computers. The four of us formed an MTG playgroup, and we also hung out with another friend who was not interested in Magic, but still enjoyed going mall shopping with us and all of this in the first month of school. Oh yeah, I also met this one guy in my history class who told me to get a bunch of books from the library about blood alchemy and convinced me that they were real, and I honestly don't know how. I still have yet to turn in the book, so I hope I can graduate, maybe I can, I don't even know at this point. Throughout freshman year, my various friends and I had our ups and downs due to my lack of social experience, but I did still make my first major development, interest in something that someone else is doing. I still have much to learn in having an interest in other people's thoughts and feelings, something I'll talk more about later on. Moving on from social life, I start to gain a passion in after-school clubs. I participated in Cyber Patriot Club and was one of the only members in 3D Printing Club. My interest started to really revolve around computers more than ever, which led me to choosing AP Computer Science as one of my sophomore year courses. So without further ado, it's time to move on to my sophomore year. At the beginning of sophomore year, it was time for clubs to start back up. In Cyber Patriot, I became an educational officer and a team captain, while I became vice president for the 3D Printing Club. Still, both those clubs met up once a week, but I wanted a club that I could spend more time in. This feeling is another step in my growth, the want to dedicate time for something unrelated to me. And so I applied to Robotics Club, a club that was led by the president of Cyber Patriot Club, and I was rejected. I was very upset because I really wanted to dedicate lots of time to something like this. Seeing me upset, the president of Robotics and Cyber Patriot Club, a friend of mine, decided to let me in Robotics Club. The year was a blast, we made it to world championships, and I learned a lot about programming. Speaking of which, remember I decided to take AP Computer Science? Well, it was a course designed to introduce people like me to programming. And, well, I found a natural beauty in programming that I could find nowhere else. Just the ability to solve problems way more efficiently than otherwise possible gave me a love for CS. And not just programming, CS as a whole. And my CS teacher, I am grateful that she taught me 2 years of computer science while being an awesome teacher. From this point until now, CS has been what I want to pursue in the future. As far as friends go, I met 2 more Langley kids at a local game store where my playgroup plays Magic, and so they joined the playgroup, making us a group of 6. Then I met someone in my chemistry class who was just completely towers over me in height, but he also played Magic, joining the playgroup. Also in PE class, I joined a friend group, and in that group, one more person also played Magic and joined our playgroup. Finally, my friend who took the group to the mall decided to join our Magic group. Throughout this time, I didn't have many awestrucking developments, but our group grew from 4 to 9. Though I still lack care for others' thoughts, so there were tensions between me and some of the other people in the group. Unfortunately, by the end of the school year, my best friend at the time, the one who would take our group mall shopping, moved to Hawaii, which seriously impacted us. We just didn't hang out as much, and so the downward spiral started and continued into junior year. Well, junior year is that time when you have to put out your best for colleges. Also, the 2 seniors in our group were actually doing college apps. My best friend was in Hawaii, and every other junior in the Magic group was also working hard to get good grades. So we just kind of stopped hanging out entirely. Yeah, we made a school MTG club, but it was only 1 hour every 2 weeks. Because of this, I began to become extremely stressed and have lots of anxiety. And so I got addicted to YouTube as my only way to escape anything. But this didn't come out without a benefit. In fact, I have YouTube's recommended videos algorithm to thank a lot for what I'm about to bring up. It recommended me the video titled One Punch Man Fitness Test. I don't know what appealed to me about this video, but on the same night, I ended up finishing all of One Punch Man, my first anime, and it hit me hard. It's about a hero who has reached an infinite amount of strength, and it delves into how depressed he is because he has nothing to live for, since he's already reached his ultimate goal to become the strongest. It made me realize how even though I seemed fine on the outside, I was falling on the inside. And it was at this point that I decided to watch different anime series to reduce some stress and anxiety. Even though our MTG group didn't hang out a lot, I still had various classes with most of my friends, and this also helped relieve stress in school. And this also gave me an opportunity to branch out and meet people who weren't particularly interested in Magic, but were still great friends. In my physics class, one of the members in our playgroup sat 2 chairs away from me, and in between us was a guy with a shiny Razer RGB laptop and a big following on YouTube. And we talked about what's up a lot in class. Now, we didn't talk much outside of class, but you'll see why this is so important later on. I still attended all the same clubs. I became president in 3D printing club, but that doesn't really matter all that much. Well, now that I could drive, I went to robotics club pretty much every day after school and stayed till about 8 or so every night. Yes, even with all the homework load that I had. It was something I enjoyed very much, and I ended up being chosen as a captain for my senior year, which I'll start to talk about now. So as the first semester of senior year unfolded, well, the stress and anxiety levels were the same as junior year, except for me, it was the final test, and there was a point where I was in one of the lowest emotional peaks I'd ever been in. At this point, the Magic playgroup didn't even exist anymore. Half the people in the group were off to college, and the other half, including me, were working on college apps. Because they were my main friend group, it was a huge blow. I still made a few friends from class. Also, things between me and one of my friends were really just awful. So basically, in sophomore year, a video game we both played, Paragon, shut down, and he decided to dedicate himself to remaking a game, and I gave him lots of crap for it, which he did not take lightly. When I went onto his server for the remake of the game, and wrote, "Is the server still alive?" when it was clearly a dead server, that was when he indefinitely held a grudge against me, and rightfully so. And no matter what, I never felt sorry for saying the things I said at that point. Also at this point in time, I had very few friends, and my emotional state was at its lowest ever. Like, it was seriously bad, and it was a series of great things that brought me out of depression. A few days later, I watched an anime that changed my perspective on others, Steins Gate, a time travel anime that evolves into an emotional work of art like no other. Like, I couldn't stop crying, and I'm sorry. I just want to say that, in general, anime, in my opinion, are so much better written than books, even created by some of the best authors. The bestsellers that various authors wrote that English teachers force us to read don't even compare to the best anime series in plot, characters, theme, philosophy, pretty much everything that your English teacher will claim these books to do better than anything else. Back to Steins Gate. I'm not going to spoil anything specific, but I will say that one of the themes from this anime is how every person seems normal and happy, while in reality they all have lost something very meaningful to them. I won't elaborate any further than that due to spoilers. All I'll say is that Steins Gate portrays this theme so well, and it made me understand how everyone has bad things happen to them, and no matter what anyone seems to feel, in reality you have to be careful of what you say. And I regret everything I said to my friend about this game remake, and I want to take back everything I did. In a way, I was a little more happy, but also more sad at the same time. I was now at my lowest point ever. So remember the person who convinced me that blood alchemy was real in freshman year? And the person who sat next to me in physics class junior year? I don't think I could thank them enough for what they did. I don't know if they realized how lonely and depressed I was, or if they decided to do what I'm about to say at that time just by coincidence, but they invited me to something that ended my downward spiral of depression. A Discord gaming server that many of their friends and some of my friends were a part of. When I joined the server, well, many of the people who didn't originally know me didn't understand what the situation I was in, so they would roast me on my lack of gaming knowledge, like all people do to each other from time to time. They are all generally awesome people to talk to, but just didn't know what I was going through. Along with all my friends that were on the server, I want to really thank two people who I previously didn't know who just always rose my spirit. And I'll put their profile pictures on the screen right now. They all helped me get out of my lowest point and shot me up to my highest point ever. About a month later, it was time for the robotics season to start back up again, and I continued to dedicate all my time to Robotics Club once again, and Langley became a finalist in our second competition. Unfortunately, the season and like the rest of the school year was cut short by a certain, let's say worldwide disaster. But it was still alright. So a few months later, I'm stuck at home and I can't leave the house. I spend the majority of my time in the Discord server I mentioned about a minute ago, and I'm taking online AP exams this week, and I'm going to Purdue University as a computer science major. I'm happy where I am, and I want you to understand how beautiful my high school experience was. You know how I describe myself as empty at the beginning of high school? Well now, I would describe myself as anything but that. A complete person ready to go on to the next journey, college.
Wait, who are you?
I thought you didn't want to know who I was.
I'm sorry about what I said earlier. Just please, I want to know, who are you?
Well, I'm you.
Wait, what?
I'm you. 4 years in the future. I'm what you are going to be 4 years from now.
Wow, really? Wait, can I ask you more about your high school experience?
You could, but you are asleep now, and you won't remember anything when you wake up anyways. If you did, remember me talking about a paradox earlier? Well, it would cause one, so you definitely won't remember. Similar to me telling you specific names. Oh yeah, about that. It seems like it's time for you to get off the bus.
Wait, hold on. If I'm forgetting all of this, then why tell me in the first place?
Because I want you to know that everything's going to be alright.
Well, thank you.
Oh, okay, whatever. I don't care anyway. I won't be tardy. Oh shoot, it's 8:09. I hope that the corner of the room is open in all my classes today. Huh, why do I think this? Probably just a hunch. And just to remind you, that single thought caused everything else that happened. A fair amount of my high school experience, the MTG group, friends in other classes, senior depression, the Discord server, all the indirect result of where I decided to sit for my first weeks of class. Still, I'm grateful for everything that happened. To show my grace, I'm going to be creating a teacher appreciation video, and I'll send it to every single teacher who helped me throughout high school. Thank you all for an amazing high school experience.